This is the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.
Good evening, I'm Melanie Chartoff, and these are tonight's top stories. With Libyan hit squads apparently roaming all over the North American continent, it was announced this morning that the Libyans will be organized into a cohesive unit and become the latest team added to the American League for the upcoming season. Now, although Libyan strongman Muammar al-Gaddafi has denied that he sent a hit squad to assassinate President Reagan or some of our top officials, the United States continues to insist the plot is real. Now, here to get to the bottom of this is everyone's pal, Larry David.
Thanks, Mel. Thank you. Let me say something right now. I've known Mo Gaddafi ever since I was a kid. And I just can't believe that my old pal Mo would hatch a plan to assassinate Reagan. Not the Mo I know.
Well, Larry, what do you intend to do about this situation?
Well, I intend to give my old buddy boy Mo a call, Mel.
All right. Well, it seems that Larry David is going to be calling up his old pal Muammar al-Gaddafi on our phone right here. Let's watch.
Colonel.
Colonel Gaddafi.
Colonel Gaddafi. No.
Colonel Gaddafi. Sorry, Larry.
Hello?
I got a sausage pizza here for Muammar Gaddafi.
But I did not order a pie.
All right, then. I'll just leave it in the lobby for the hit squad. Mo! Mo! What's doing?
Not much. What's doing with you?
nothing. I went to New York for Thanksgiving.
Oh, terrific! Did you see what's her name?
no. She hates my guts. She wants to kill me. I guess you can identify with that one, huh, Butcher Boy?
I'd rather be a Butcher Boy than a Mr. Four Eyes!
So, I saw you on the Brinkley Show last week. What's going on with all this Hitman Reagan stuff?
Nothing. Did you like my cape? Huh?
Yeah, good-looking cape, Mo. Yeah, great cape. Yeah, come on, what's going on?
Come on, Larry, I don't want to talk about this.
Hey, come on, Mo, you're talking to the Dipper.
I know, Dipper, but I just don't feel like talking about it. You know, remember 3 years ago when we spent Christmas at Club Med?
Oh, yeah. Whoa, that was some vacation, huh?
Remember the night of the cookout when you took that redhead back to our cabin and I had to sleep on the beach?
Yeah.
And then at breakfast the next day, I tried to get some good sex details and you told me to mind my own business. So now you want to know something and all of a sudden I'm supposed to hand over the information? Well, no. You give me no details, I give you no details.
Yeah? Hey, look, Napoleon, I think there's a little bit of difference between fondling some redhead's breast and planning to assassinate the President of the United States.
Yeah, well, maybe if you'd feel a little different if you had to sleep out on that cold beach.
Come on, you're being silly, you're acting like a child.
You can't talk to me like that, I'll kill you for eyes.
Shut up!
Well, Larry, I hope you two can catch things up.
This Mo is a hot-headed guy, and I'm going to tell you something. He's a big jerk, and I think that I've had it with him. I'm not calling him anymore.
But, Larry...
No buts. I can't... No more with Mo. I've had it with him.
Well, in other news... President Reagan said this week the striking air traffic controllers could return to the federal payroll, but not to their old jobs. Reagan said the controllers can work in any area of government except for that which they are qualified. This same rule will continue to apply to members of the president's cabinet. More news right after this.
And now, another important message from Brooke Shields.
Hi, I'm Brooke Shields. And when something in this world isn't right, I feel it's my responsibility to tell you about it. You know, I think foreign people would do better in a different country. Thank you.
This has been one in a series of important messages from Brooke Shields.
Well, it seems the man from Texaco will have a new look this year. The latest design in gas station attendant uniforms was revealed this week. And company officials say the new uniform allows for greater freedom of movement and the sword discourages customer complaints over prices. Now, this is a rather bizarre story. A hallucination first seen by Dr. Timothy Leary in 1967 reappeared this week on Route 80 near Omaha, Nebraska. The vision, a polar bear wearing a blue Nehru suit, is drawing large crowds from all over the Midwest. In a related story, this week, Secretary of the Interior James Watt appeared before a congressional subcommittee to answer charges that he is, in reality, Elmer Fudd. Watt admitted the deception, but refused to resign, telling committee members, "I'm going to get that wascally wabbit if I have to strip mine ever-wee coward patch in this country." I'm Melanie Charter for the Flighty Edition. Have a terrific weekend.
This has been the Friday Edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.